Hello, David Clark here from DVC Training, and I'm just going to do a short video talking about all the different programs that I use in my everyday editing work. You can see a list of the different programs in the description below, and if you don't want to see why, for example, I might choose Edius for editing over Resolve, you can just jump forward to the next bit. So for editing, I mainly favour Edius. For effects and finishing off, I use DaVinci Resolve. Also inside of Edius, I use plugins called Neat Video, which is great for cleaning up video, and Acoustica, which is great for cleaning up sound. I upscale and deinterlace using a couple of programs called Topaz and StaxRip, which I have done some other videos about. For pictures, eFoto. When it comes to 3D graphics and animation, it's a free program called Blender. And then I've got a couple of utilities I use all the time. There's one for syncing up files between different directories called Free File Sync. Another one called Windostat, which just helps me work out where stuff is on my drives. And I also use Google Docs quite a lot for sharing stuff with other people. So I'm just going to briefly go through all of those, explain why I like them, and then you can decide whether they'll be helpful to you. So anyway, let's get straight on. First thing, what do I prefer to use for editing? For editing, I mainly use Edius, although I have been using DaVinci Resolve quite a bit as well. I still find when it comes down to the actual editing and putting stuff together, getting stuff done quickly, Edius is the best for me. It's not just because I know it very, very well, because I've spent a lot of time doing things in Resolve, and I know that pretty well as well. Also, I know Premiere very well, because I've been using that for donkey's years ever since Premiere Pro 1 in about 93. So, I have edited stuff in all of them, but I still find Edius is the one that I get on with quickest. It's just there's less clicks, there's so many things which, you know, they're just where you need them to be. Whereas like in Resolve, sticking something on the timeline, I had to click a couple of things first quite a bit to get it to do what I want. As an example, one thing that does irritate me quite a lot is dragging clips on the timeline inside of Resolve. So I've got a clip here on the timeline, I want to bring another one in, you can grab it, drag it from the bin, put it on the timeline, it brings the audio and the video. Or you can double click on it, put it up in the player, grab it and drop it. Or you can drag it and use one of these things over here. These will work fine, no problem at all. What irritates me is, suppose I've got a timeline full of stuff and I just want to drag on a bit of video without audio. Well, in Resolve, you have to double click on it, shove it in here, and you can grab hold of that and it just drags the video and not the audio. Or you can come down here, click on this, and then just drag straight from here. And it basically brings in just the video, not the audio. Fine, no problem at all. The trouble is, I do it again, and I do it again, and I do it again, and just sometimes you double click on this, you put something up in the source, changes all these patches around, the A comes back on again, so the next time you want to do it, so you start dragging, oh fudge, the A is selected, let's go. Let's unclick this, then let's do it again. Now you might say, that's pretty minor, David. Yeah, a lot of the stuff is pretty minor, but it adds up if you have to do a lot of it during an editing session. Now in Edius, same kind of thing. You've got a clip on the timeline, you want to drag another one in. Obviously you bring it in, it brings in the sound and the picture. Or you can put it up in the source, drag it, drop it down here. Now if you don't want the sound, you just unclick the A. And then when you drag it, brings it in without sound. Now so far, same number of clicks. The thing is though, Edius stays like that until you tell it not to be. And now I can drag a clip from anywhere. I can go to Explorer and I can grab a clip from Explorer and shove it straight onto the timeline without even putting it into the bin. And it goes straight in there. You try and do that in Resolve, more likely than not, it's going to go wrong. I mean, you can grab things and bring them in for Explorer. Sometimes it'll work. A lot of the times it won't. It just seems to reset when it feels like it. Some of the new things they've put into Edius X, you know, I want to export something. And normally I'd go to print file and choose a format. But, you know, you can save your own presets. You can set them as the default. So suppose I set as a default there. That's my first preset. I can stick a button up here. So let's go into the user settings, recorder, and say print to file default exporter. Add that button in. Now that I've done that and I've set a default, I can just click on that and it will automatically go straight to the file that I want to export. You know, with all the settings and everything else that you set up. You know, it's just quicker. There's a lot of little things about that that just make life quicker inside of Edius, and they do add up over a while when you're really intensely editing something very big and complicated. That's not to say that Edius is perfect, and there are things I would like it to do better. But I just think overall, the editing side of it is better. And yeah, with luck, they'll improve Resolve and it'll do things better. But they are trying to please so many people all of the time. They're bunging so many different things in and different ways of doing stuff. They're not kind of settling on something and streamlining, if you like. I go to Resolve because I'm particularly doing a project that needs a lot of tidying up. So some of you may know this, but a long time ago, before I started the company, I started making a Doctor Who fan film. And it got to be quite long, and it's 6 episodes, and we never got round to finishing it because of starting the company, work, families, all that kind of thing. We're finishing it now. It's all filmed on standard definition. It's got to be upscaled. There's got to be lots of effects in it. And I've got hundreds of hours of footage. We're talking 150 hours worth of footage in this thing. So it's a lot of stuff to manage. It's got to be edited and gone over and trimmed and everything else. Still a lot quicker to do it in Edius, but then I can then pop into Resolve to do effects and tidying up. I use other programs as well, which I have done videos about. But yeah. Edius is my favorite for editing and for a lot of simple projects. If I'm just taking some videos like this tutorial and chopping it up, still find it quicker to do it in Edius than to do it in Resolve or Premiere. Like I said, I use Resolve for lots of effects and cleaning up. So a lot of work goes into that on my Doctor Who thing, where I've got to fix dropouts. The grading, of course, is great. And I am learning Fusion a lot to do a lot of effects. Used to use After Effects a lot, but I've just stayed away from the Adobe stuff these days, mainly because you have to pay for it every month, and I don't like doing that. Not when I can find alternatives that do exactly what I want, and I don't have to pay for it every month. Now, if I didn't have to pay for After Effects every month, maybe I'd carry on using it. But I do, so I've been looking for alternatives, and I've settled on Resolve and using the Fusion part of it for an awful lot of my compositing. And I'm going to do some videos about learning Resolve. Well, there are quite a few out there, but I will do some videos on various bits of it that will hopefully help people in the future. As far as plugins go, the two plugins that I use in Edius the most are Neat Video, which is great for getting rid of noise. Again, if you go into Resolve, it's got that built in the studio version, but I still think Neat Video is better. So I do use that in Edius a lot. And I also use Acoustica plugins. So Edius has got some in there, but you can buy a suite of extra plugins. And I particularly like the AI voice isolation plugin. Resolve has now got something like this built into the studio version. But what it does is it uses artificial intelligence to isolate a voice and get rid of everything else. And I just use that a lot in Edius on my videos now. More or less for noise reduction, getting rid of all the crap in the background. For example,
they're not my laws of time, I don't believe in them. That's what all this is about.
But then I put on this Acoustica plugin in Edius, and now this is what it sounds like.
They're not my laws of time, I don't believe in them. That's what all this is about.
Which is not bad at all. A lot clearer, got rid of a lot of the background noise. Now, if you have watched my Doctor Who videos, which are 4x3 standard definition, you will see that there's several things going on. First of all, I've cleaned it up, deinterlaced it, and upscaled it, which I do using a couple of programs which I have done videos about on my channel. So I'm using Topaz Video AI for the upscaling, and I am using a thing called StaxRip for deinterlacing. Have a look at these videos if you want to know a bit more about those. So I use those an awful lot because I'm upscaling old-fashioned footage. Then I start cleaning them up. So inside of Resolve, I will get rid of dropout and stuff like that, and then grade it and so on. The other thing I have to do is take it from being 4x3 to widescreen. What I have to do most of the time is just zoom into it and chop bits off. But sometimes I will take the frame and then fill in the edges. So for example, in this shot here in the quarry, we've got people at the bottom, Dalek at the top, and of course, if I zoom in, I won't be able to see both of them because I'll have to chop off the top or the bottom. So I need to fill in the edges. Now to do this, I will actually take a still image of this, pop it into another program, and then fill in the edges. And to do that, I use Affinity Photo. To be honest, Photoshop can do this very well, but again, I'm trying to avoid having to pay monthly for Adobe stuff. So I use Affinity Photo, which is a one-off fee of generally about 50 quid. And then you can use it forever. So I take a still image out of here, pop it into Affinity Photo, select the edges and use what's called the in painting option. And then it fills in the edges nicely for me. If that doesn't completely fill it up, then I'll just use the clone tool to paint over the edges as well. And then I'll pop it back into my editing program, put the 4x3 thing on top. And hey presto, I've got a wider shot. But I do find the best thing to do is export it as a TIFF. If I say export as a PNG file, for some reason the color changes, which actually is the same in Resolve. But if I export it as a TIFF and then take it into Affinity and play with it, then I don't get the color changing. And that's the other program that I use quite a lot. For anything photographic, I will use Affinity Photo. Mainly if I'm fiddling with photos, what I'm doing is doing things like making clean plates up for effects, but I will also use it because I might make a montage of stills to celebrate something, somebody's birthday. Do that all in Affinity these days. Don't have to go to Photoshop for it at all. The only thing I might use Photoshop for is colorizing black and white video. And I shall do a video on this, which will be on my YouTube channel soon, so you can see why I use it. And the reason I'm not using Affinity for that is that Affinity doesn't colorize black and white photos using AI, and Photoshop does. But otherwise, everything I want to do, I can do in Affinity photo-wise, and that's what I use. Now, the other thing that I use for effects is a program called Blender. In my Doctor Who videos, we have some big CGI sequences. So we've augmented existing scenes with CGI backgrounds. We've done some straight CGI sequences. When we filmed them originally, they were going to be stop motion or model work. Now they're all CGI. And to do that, I use a thing called Blender. The thing about Blender is it does very good quality, it's got huge amounts of features, and it is completely free. The hard bit is learning how to use it. Frankly, any 3D program is hard to learn because you're trying to create an entire world and fly around it and animate it, and that's never going to be easy until AI takes over the world and you just say, make me a scene with thousands of Daleks in firing a big weapon into the sky and it'll do it. But I've tried lots of 3D programs. I've used Lightwave. I've used Cinema 4D. I think Cinema 4D is probably a little bit easier, but it'll cost you about £1,000. And also Blender actually renders things a bit nicer than Cinema 4D because it's got a better renderer thing called the Cycles Engine. Now, if you don't need to make 3D worlds, you'll never go into this. But if you want to fiddle around with making 3D worlds, I would definitely recommend having a go with Blender because it is completely free and it will remain completely free for all sorts of reasons to do with why it was made up. And it's staggering what you can do for absolutely nothing apart from time and having a fairly decent computer that can render stuff. So all my CG stuff these days is done in Blender. Compositing either in Edius or Resolve using Fusion. There's also a couple of utilities that I use quite a lot. First one is this thing. It's called Free File Sync. Obviously, you ask for a donation if you really like it. But basically, what it is a way of syncing up a couple of directories. So I use two or three different computers. That means I'm forever moving projects between them, and I want to make sure all the media goes with it. Well, what I do is to set up a folder on a computer across the network and a folder here, and I use this thing to synchronize them. So there's loads of different ways you can set it up. I've actually got it set up so that everything that's on one side will be transferred over to the other, and then everything on the other will be deleted. But I've also got it to set that when stuff is deleted, it moves it into another folder. So rather than deleting it, it just goes away. So if you realized you've made a mistake in the synchronization or you've lost something you should have done, it's still there, it's just somewhere else. Loads of ways you can set this up, but I recommend if you want to kind of mirror a couple of directories and you don't want to set up a RAID, which is the other way of doing it, if you're just doing it by, say, making sure that whatever's on this drive goes onto an external or whatever's on this particular folder goes into another folder on another computer, I use this all the time and it saved me a lot of hassle. Used to have to do it manually just by copying files over and making sure I just copied the right ones and didn't delete the wrong ones. Now I can just use this, click, leave it to get on with it, syncs everything up, and then I have a mirror of my main folder with all my stuff in on another computer, open up the project, and it's all linked straight away. I don't have to worry about anything else. Great little program, definitely worth having. Another little one I use, which I do put on all the machines that I make up, is this one, which is a thing called WinDirStat. Win directory statistics, basically. And this is just very useful for going through and finding out where all your stuff is or your space is used up. So for example, here I can just say scan all my drives and show me where the stuff is, or choose a particular drive and scan that, and for example tell me in my folder here, my Devious folder, that's the name of my Doctor Who thing, I've got 637 gig in the episode 4 folder. And most of it's in this one, and then I can look at all the individual scenes. You know, I've actually decided on this layout of files myself. What it's telling me is which ones have got the most stuff in. So like this folder has got the most stuff in. And it may be if you look into that, you find, oh, well, it's got 11 gig in there. And you may find out some of this is duplicates or things you're not actually using. Obviously, I'd have to go back to the original project and check. But at least it tells me where all the space is being used up. That's all it does. It just analyzes your drive and tells you where the space is, but you might suddenly find you've got 30 gigs in a folder which is supposed to be empty. Or if you're using Adobe, for example, you might have a load of Adobe cache files somewhere and you didn't know how big they were. Well, this suddenly points out to you, oh, there they are. There's 50 gigabytes in that folder of cache files you can dump. Love this program. Again, nice little free one that I use all the time, just because it helps me pinpoint where all my space is being used. The other thing I do use quite a bit these days is Google Docs. I don't actually do that many spreadsheets or Word documents, so I don't want to pay for Office. If I want one that's not on the internet, I'd use LibreOffice, which is completely free, does everything I need. But I do find I use Google Docs. It then syncs across several computers, so I can look at it anywhere, and it does everything I want. So, for example, we set up a little spreadsheet with all the different effect shots needed for a particular episode, and we could write notes to each other because it was shared between us very easily. And I just find Google Docs pretty much does everything that I want. Anyway, I hope you found that little roundup useful, maybe pointing you towards some programs that you haven't thought about using before. You can find out more information about editing and effects, particularly Edius and Resolve, on my website, www.dvctraining.co.uk, and also on my YouTube channel. Of course, don't forget to like and subscribe and do all the other things you're supposed to do on YouTube stuff. And I'll see you next time!